heating control. TIAC or SCR is used for the heating control of the furnace. Already we studied that when current passing through this resistance, it produces some amount of heat, and this produced heat is given by H is equal to I square by RT. Now the current passing through this element is changed by changing the firing angle of this triac. Thus heating control can be achieved. So here R is the heating elements, that means it is act as a loads, and the diac and triac are connected as shown in this figure. Here R and C is the phase control circuit for the or the gate control circuit for the triac, and the resistance R2 and C2 is a snubber circuit which is connected in parallel with the triac. So it provides dv by dt protection to this triac. Now when during the positive half cycle of input cycle, terminal A becomes positive in compared to terminal B, that time this capacitor is start to charge through this variable resistance R. Now when the potential difference across this capacitor exponentially increase, and when the potential difference across this capacitor is greater than the breakdown voltage of this diac, approximately 30 volt, that time this diac offers very low resistance, or you can say that zero, so that this charge capacitor is discharged through gate and empty two terminal of the triac, which will turn on the triac, and the current start to flows from terminal A to load, then MT1, then MT2, and the B terminal of the supply. Now similarly, during the negative half cycle of the input supply, the terminal B becomes positive in compared to terminal A, and that time this capacitor C is start to charge in reverse direction, and when the reverse voltage across this capacitor becomes higher than this diac, this diac offers very low resistance, and this reverse charge capacitor is discharged through the gate and MT2 terminal of this triac, which will turn on the triac. So the current is start to flow in reverse direction, and it follows right from terminal B to MT2, then MT1, and then load, and then terminal A. So here we can say that the heating control can be achieved by changing the value of this variable resistance. Now if we increase the value of this resistance R, the capacitor takes more time to full charge, which will decay the firing angle of this triac, and it will turn on late. So the current passing through this heating element is decreased, which decrease the heat produced by this heating element. So we can say that the heat control can be done or can be achieved by this variable resistance R, and so it is most important. Now next, this heat control using SCR. Now the SCR is used for the heat control of higher capacity of the furnace. So as shown in this figure, because we are using AC supply for that, we are using two SCR, thyristor 1 and thyristor 2, for the heating control of the furnace. Here these two SCRs are connected in anti-parallel. R2 and C2 is a snubber circuit which provides dv by dt protection to the thyristor TH1 and thyristor T2. Here R is the heating elements. So there are two methods are used for this heating control by using this SCR. First, in first method, each and every SCR, both SCRs are triggered during the positive half cycle element as well as negative half cycle, during the negative half cycle. So here the main disadvantage, the input power factors becomes poor, and the value of power factor is very poor if the firing angle is more. So that is the main disadvantage of this method. Because you can say that thyristor 1 is turned on in positive half cycle Lermian during the positive half cycle, and the thyristor TH2 turn on the negative half cycle. So to overcome this power factor problem, we are using another method. Now in this method, the thyristor is turned on for some input cycle and it is turned off for some cycle. So that means there is no it is eliminated the power factor problems. So here your thyristor is operated really full half cycle. That means the firing angle alpha is equal to zero. That means there is no effect on the power factor. That's why this method is called integral control method. So by the changing the value, the heating control can be achieved by changing the value of turn off period as well as turn on period.